Okay, so now let's go ahead and look at the projections that these guys were using. I'm gonna first look at this guy, open him up in a new tab, and then I'm gonna look at this guy, open him up in a new tab. And so this was the first stab they had, and it looks to me like it's centered on North Korea, but the middle of the map still seems to be, does it look like it doesn't look like the middle of the map is way down here on the equator. It looks like they've kind of centered the map on North Korea, versus this is, they're still displaying it that way, but they've clearly done something to give this kind of parabola shape. So let's start with seeing if we can figure out what projection they used to kind of to make the map look like this. And so I'm going to go ahead and open up ArcMap, and I'm going to close this table. And I'm going to zoom out to the Easter egg world here. And right now we are in, if I go to the properties, WGS 84. Now, what would happen if I went down to projected and then, let's see, used a world, and if I found something here called the Mercator and said, okay. That's starting to look like kind of the world that we're familiar with when we have this like huge Antarctica and this huge Greenland, and this is the kind of distorted world of that we're used to kind of looking at. And to just kind of maybe do this a little bit more, I'm going to go to the properties, go to grids, say new grid, and I'm going to show a graticule on top of this thing, and I'd like the parallels to be every, let's say, 15. And I'm going to say next. And I'm going to avoid that. And I'm going to, for now. And I'm going to avoid the simple border. So I'd like that actually to be no color. And I think that'll clean it up a little bit. And say finish. And say OK. And now what I should get here is absolutely nothing. But if I went over to here, I should now get this map with that on it. So, right, so now I'm looking at a page view and I've got the graticule on there. And let's set this up so that I have my page and print view. I'm going to do a landscape and say okay. I'm going to add my guides by clicking right there, and right there, and right there, and right there, and then I'm going to add one guide right in the half, right in the middle. So the middle of 11 is basically 5.5. And then I'm going to take this guy, and I should get him to stick to that, and wait patiently. And you know what? I'm going to turn that off so that I just have the graticule so that it draws faster. It's going to stick there. And I'm going to bring this guy down. It's going to stink like that. And now I'm going to use the paper zoom in and out to zoom back into here. And then if I add the world countries, there it is, right? So we're clearly distorting our northern latitudes by the t right, because the rectangles keep on getting bigger and bigger as you go to the northern or the southern latitudes, but the higher latitudes we are distorting. Fair enough. Okay, so now let's compare this to what the economists did. And here is their first attempt. And there's a couple things that are different about their map. You'll notice that it's basically centered on North Korea in the sense that North Korea is appearing in the center of the map, and then there's geographic information to the east and to the west of North Korea. If you look at our map, first of all, it's really difficult to find North Korea, and second of all, it's not centered on it. So let's do that first part first, because I think I've reached my limit on looking at this. So if we go ahead to World Countries, double-click on it, go to Features, click on this. I'm going to make this guy kind of a light gray, and I'm going to turn the outline to none and say okay, okay. And then I'm going to go up here and double click on North Korea and make this guy some kind of Christmassy red, poinsettia red. That's exactly what I want. And so that should help us see North Korea over there on this kind of base map, without all the kind of clutter of the coastline and the other stuff that was on that original version of it. And so now what we'd like to do is center this guy, and you might think, well, hey, isn't that as easy as grabbing, Michael Jackson here and dragging it over so that it's approximately centered based on this little guy here, and then just waiting for it, and then just it, should kind of fill in there, but it doesn't. There's nothing, there's no world over here. You've kind of fallen off the edge there. The world is all, everything to the east of North Korea is basically being stored over here, so it's just being kind of shoved off of the map. So you can't really kind of center your map through this method. I'm just going to start clicking back on this button to get back to my previous extents. And so I think that one's good. Nope, that one doesn't have North Korea at all. That one's not good. That's where I think we started, right? Alaska being cut off and North Korea over here. Okay, so let's review and go up to layers. And what we have is the Mercator. And the way that I think about the Mercator is that we're talking about putting a ball in a trash can, that the trash can is a cylinder. And the ball fits pretty neat. And what we have with the World Mercator is that the if it's a snug fit, there's going to be one ring around the ball that's in contact with the trash can. And that ring around the ball is the standard parallel. So in the classic Mercator, the standard parallel is the equator. The equator is the thing that's making contact, because you put it in so that north is the North Pole is kind of pointing straight up, and the South Pole is pointing straight down. And then the central meridian is deciding where on this map you are representing the center, on the flat map as it gets projected. Does that make sense? So the central meridian is zero, which is Greenwich, which is basically right in here, which is the center of our map. And we could always throw, I'm not sure if this kind of business helps you see that at all, but we can throw that on and then grab this guy and wait for it. And the lines got canceled, but if they come back, you can then zoom. And I've grabbed the zoom in on the paper one, and you go up here and you should see that that guy is zero, right? And so now I'm going to click this guy, which is going to zoom back to my extent on the paper, and then take off of that graticule. Okay. So now what I'd like to do is change that so that we're centered on North Korea. And if I go to layers, go to coordinate system, what I'd like to do is change the central meridian. And I can't do it. If I double click on it, nothing. If I double click on this guy, it pops up. And so it's going to allow me to kind of customize this world Mercator. And so I'm going to say this is what I want is the Economist North Korea map in the Mercator, which is pretty long-winded, but and it's based on the Mercator. And now what I get to do here is let's just start with changing the central meridian. And so now I'm going to type in that number that we wrote down, 2959, and I'm going to leave the standard parallel alone for right now. I'm going to leave the linear unit alone, and the ball that I'm still sticking in the cylinder, I'm still putting basically the WGS 1984 beach ball or graticule into the garbage can, but I'm just basically twisting it a little bit and rotating it around the poles so that the part that's now going to face the kind of the center of the map is defined by this longitude rather than the prime meridian or rather than zero. Is that fair so far? So if I say okay and okay, I should think about it. And now, right, there is land both to the east and to the west of North Korea. It's centered. And it's still centered so that the equator is the kind of standard parallel. This is the part of the graticule or the beach ball that is making contact with the garbage can or the cylinder. So if I wanted to change that, I could go up here. And again, I can't change it here, even though I'd like to, but I can double-click on this and bring it up here, and then I'm going to change the standard parallel, highlight the whole thing, and then it's going to be 40.14343. Okay. And saving a different version of that, which is going to make things tricky, but I'm just going to pay attention to which one I'm using. And now, dinka dinka dinka, it probably doesn't look, it hasn't shifted it, but I know at least now if I wanted to zoom in that I've got the least amount of distortion going right across North Korea rather than down here. Is that fair? If that didn't make sense, let's just talk to me. Okay, so now let's go ahead and I'm going to double click on that and change this to say this is the Mercator. And then what I'd like to do is right click on it, say copy, and then go up here and say paste. And now I'm going to make this one and say, I'm going to type in this strange word that's azimuthal. And then in here, what I'd like to do, so first of all, I'm going to take this guy and drag him on over here. All right. And then what I'm going to do in them is just turn these guys off for now and go ahead. I probably should have done this first, but it's okay. Turn the graticule on. And then I'm going to go over to the azimuthal, turn these guys off, and also turn on the graticule. Okay, so now what I'd like to do is change this projection. So what I'm doing is I'm showing you this is the projection that they kind of did their calculations in that led to the error. And then this is the, and then what I want to do over here is to show you the projection that they used to make their correction when they did it correctly. So, and we'll just kind of compare the kind of graph paper of the graticule. So let's go into here, and what they did is they did a, what they did is they did a new projected coordinate system. And this time we're going to base it on, if you go to the top, something called azimuthal equidistant. And I'm going to call this the economist azimuthal. And I'd like the central meridian of this guy to again be what we wrote down for the center of North Korea. 127.729, that looks right. Is that, and then the latitude of origin, I'm going to make this be the latitude of North Korea. And then again, I'm going to take, leave alone the GCS and just say OK. And then I'm going to say OK. And it should change that and make kind of a much more fun kind of shape. And so now if I look at North Korea, there it is in the center. Of this, and this is showing you how the graticule, there's the North Pole, there's the South Pole, is drawn around North Korea. And then this is what the world looks on this beach ball, right? And so, do you recognize that? Probably, and that? Probably. Do you recognize what this thing is? As it's kind of slowly drawing all in. Do you recognize that? It's kind of a fun way to look at the world, and if you're wondering, like, well, no, actually, I have no idea what this thing is. You can just grab the information button here and click on that, and it should tell you that's Bolivia and Paraguay, so that's actually South America, right? So anyway, that's, this is the projection that we want to do things correctly, and this is the projection that they used to do this kind of incorrectly. But we're kind of getting to be on our way here. And so I'm going to save my map because this has been kind of a fair amount of work. And then we're going to kind of keep moving.